She may no longer be able to issue statements in person, but there's no stopping detained Senator Leila de Lima from condemning the president, his men, and his war on drugs. In a handwritten note shared with the media, de Lima slams the so-called presidential defenders and asks them to refrain from insulting the intelligence of Filipinos and the rest of the world. She laments that the truth has become the first casualty of the war on drugs. She believes that in due time, the president and his men who follow his illegal orders to kill, concoct lies and evidence will be held accountable. Presidential Legal Counsel Sal Panelo hits back, saying de Lima should stop fooling herself and the people. Panelo adds de Lima only has herself to blame for the karmic debt she is undergoing. De Lima's fellow Senator Alan Peter Cayetano, who ran as Mr. Duterte's vice presidential bet, denounced de Lima and her allies for their attempts to destabilize the government.
Leila de Lima already said he's a mass murderer, he's a dictator, etc. Or he's using the power of government to... Hindi namang obvious na yon. Hindi ba distab yun?
Cayetano adds drug lords are also part of the destabilization attempts against the president.
The drug lords are not standing by. They're not doing nothing. Now, how much are they doing is for the law enforcers to do.
Cayetano also accuses de Lima and Senator Antonio Trillanes for using lies to draw public support and global attention to the Philippines.
Ang style po ng grupo ni Senator de Lima at Senator Trillanes is to weaken the court system and try to make it appear sa international community na walang law and order sa Pilipinas.
Cayetano defends the government's drug war amid the latest allegations of abuse by the international group Human Rights Watch. But he admits government can do a better job of communicating its anti-drug campaign. He sees a need to relaunch and re-explain the role of all stakeholders in the administration's war on drugs and clear the air of politics to have a truly comprehensive solution to the drug menace. Meanwhile, the Justice Department filed a motion to consolidate the three cases of illegal drug trade against Senator De Lima, with Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court Judge Juanita Guerrero handling the cases.
We cited Rule 119, Section 22, I think. Section. It's allowed under the rules.
We oppose kasi nga we feel that they want Judge Guerrero to hear the case. Well, we know naman that it was Judge Guerrero who issued the warrant of arrest against Senator De Lima.
Guerrero is set to hear the motion on March 10th. Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.